When it comes to smoke and mirrors, Donald Trump truly is the champion of political theater. Bold, bombastic, and yep, big.
We're going to win so big. Thank you very much, everybody.
And we're not just talking about his own winning predictions, because what Trump seems to have cornered too is the market on fibs, falsehoods, and outright fabrications. As in, pants on fire kind of lies.
We have a rating system, and the pants on fire rating means the statement is inaccurate and also ridiculous.
Angie Holin is the editor of PolitiFact, a nonpartisan fact-checking outlet tracking the truth according to Trump. Sure, Trump is the most fact-checked of all the 2016 candidates, but the group says that's because he puts a whole lot more out there, and a lot of it is simply made up.
We have a president that said 3,000. Now he wants to bring in 250,000 people.
In fact, the Obama administration only committed to letting in 10,000 refugees from Syria.
I watched when the World Trade Center came tumbling down. And I watched in Jersey City, New Jersey, where thousands and thousands of people were cheering.
And there were only a few people spotted cheering after the Twin Towers fell.
He just seems to have a disregard for the facts. About three quarters of the statements we have rated have either earned mostly false, false, or pants on fire.
To be sure, Trump is hardly the first politician to manipulate the facts for political gain. But his blasé disregard for the truth is so prolific, fact-checking his statements has become a flourishing feature in mainstream media too, all of which seems to matter not one bit to his core supporters.
I mean, I don't even know what lies you might even be talking about. It really doesn't even matter.
You could check facts all over the place, and one guy's going to check this way, another guy's going to check that way.
In fact, analysts say Trump expertly plays to that core base, mostly white, male, disaffected voters who don't trust the very establishments that continue to challenge Trump.
The primary audience are those angry white old guys.
Warren Kinsella is a political consultant.
He tells them the truth that they want to believe in, whatever it is, that all Muslims are terrorists or what have you. And as a consequence, he makes them feel validated.
You got to vote tomorrow, everybody.
Right on. You're in.
But real power, as in winning an election, relies on broad support, says Kinsella.
Like, he's like a car crash on the highway. There's no question, when there's a car crash on the highway, all of us, even though we don't like car crashes, we slow down to take a look. That's Donald Trump. But that doesn't mean we want more car crashes. That just means we're looking.
It will be months before that decisive vote. And truth be told, or not, until then, Trump certainly knows how to keep people looking. Ioana Bermiliotis, CBC News, Toronto.